today's a good day. Today we're talking about hammered ornamental bars. Why you should use it, how to use it, and how it will make you extra money. Oh, I love this stuff. Now, the unfortunate thing about decorative bar is, well, I just don't think it's used enough. Now, even in the design concepts catalog that I preach about so much from King, even they in there, I don't think they use decorative bar as much as they could. Now, the thing about decorative bar is, you know, yeah, it does cost a little bit more and it's usually sort of a heavier material to work with. In a lot of cases, of course, you can get some of the stuff in lighter gauge and tubing form. But the problem is it does raise the cost a little bit. And sometimes that's kind of a hard sell. So in terms of changing your project, it doesn't really change the way you're going to be putting anything together. All you're really doing is just taking some plain Jane material and switching it out with something a little more ornate and a little more, pizzazz. Something with a little more pizzazz, right? And pizzazz is always nice to see on railings and gates and fences, and this is an easy way to switch it out and an easy way to make a little bit more money off the project. Now, yes, these more ornate materials do cost more, and a lot of times it's kind of hard to justify spending a little extra money on something like a post. But don't underestimate the power of a hammered bar. So I'm gonna give you two of my favorite ways to use ornamental bar, and then I'm also gonna give you a way on how you can justify that price, not only to yourself, but also to the client to make it worth their while. So for me, it's pretty simple. I like to take things like end posts and just switch those out for something a little more nice, a little hammered stuff here and there. Maybe even use some of this twisted bar. You can get this twisted bar pretty thick now. I know this is a little cliche because everyone under the sun has seen twisted bar because it's been done since the dawn of time. But when you add that into like a post, it looks super cool and not something you see very often. Now the other way that I really like to use, and probably my favorite way to use bar, is I actually like to use the hammered flat bar quite a bit. I like to use the hammered flat bar as a handrail. Instead of using a normal cap rail, I love to use hammered stuff or anything like this with texture as the actual cap rail going on top of a railing or a fence or a gate. I just love the way that this looks because it's kind of plain, but when the light hits these hammered portions just right, it just adds that texture. It looks beautiful. Now, of course, you don't just have to stick with the hammered stuff and the twist stuff that we've talked about here. Go on the King website and look through the stuff that they have. They have a ton of different decorative bars. Some of the stuff is super cool and would look absolutely beautiful on interior rails where the painting is just nice. Oh, just beautiful stuff, beautiful stuff. Go check that out and see how you can add that into your project. Now, in terms of justifying this to the client, is when you're pitching this idea and the design, the project, don't come into it as, here are some upgrades that we can do to make this design better. No, start with everything that you want in the design as the baseline. Shoot for the moon first. And if they balk at that price or to the design, then you can always take away. You can come back from that. But it's much harder to add stuff to it than it is to take away. So start with that, the end of what you want in mind, and then work your way back if you need to. All right, guys, that's it for this one. If you have some examples of some cool work that you've done using decorative bar in interesting ways, I would love to see it. Post links below if you have any videos or pictures of anything that you guys have done using decorative bar. Decorative bar is just something that is just not used enough in my opinion. And a little bit goes a long way. So I wanna see your projects down below. Let's see them. All right, bye.